district for 22 years, since I was 18. I turned 40 today. I decided to spend my birthday here with all of you, my 40th birthday no less, because this issue means that much to me. Tomorrow's another day, we can drink then. I'll still be 40 then. So, yeah, the minimum wage is $2.89 an hour. I started waiting tables at Friendly's on Reservoir Ave when I was 18. I was still a senior in high school. I made $2.13 an hour plus tips. I needed to get a second job to pay my $375 a month rent. Today, that one-bedroom apartment on the east side that I lived down, that was $375, I bet you anything is probably $1,000 plus. It was right near Miriam Hospital. It was on 8th and Highland, my apartment, which is right in Miriam Hospital area. I worked at Greg's, actually on North Main Street, and I worked at Friendly's. I used to walk to work at Greg's. It was hard. I worked sometimes 70 hours a week, and I just scraped by. I didn't take vacations. I didn't go out to eat. I didn't go to the movies. What we did for fun, friends would come over. We'd rent a movie from Blockbuster back in the VHS days, and sit in my apartment and watch movies. That's what we did for fun. And today, minimum wage for tipped workers is $2.89, a few cents more than the $2.13 I made back then. But when you look at the cost of living now versus then, and you look at the wage, now it's a little bit more, and the cost of living is three times more. It's just, we have to raise this wage. We have to do this. We have to do this for women. We have to do this for servers. I mean, we're not second-class citizens. We're not a number on a, we're not a number on a spreadsheet. We're not a bottom line. We're human beings. And we need to support ourselves, and we need to support our families. There are nights that I would leave work with $10 in my pocket. And that happened more frequently than you think. Not every night is a Friday night when you walk home with $100 in your pocket. I mean, there are some nights where you're literally doing side work all night long, scrubbing bar sinks, wiping down bottles, cleaning floors, cleaning out traps in the dishwashers for $2.89 an hour. $2.89 an hour. At best, they up you to $9 if they're in compliance. And that's, you know, if they're in compliance, we're getting $9 an hour for that. And that's only for the last few months we've been getting $9. Before that, it was $8. So why should every other industry get an increase and not the tip servers? It's we need it, you know? Contrary to popular belief, people think that, you know, waitresses and bartenders are just raking in the money with this big golden rake, you know? And it's not the case. I got divorced 6 years ago. I've been bartending since then. I've been on food stamps since then. I've had neighborhood health plans, subsidized health care since then. Because I had to, not because I wanted to, because I had to. We need to do this to help the Rhode Island be able to contribute to this economy. If I made enough money, I'd love to go to the movies. I'd love to go out to eat. I'd love to take my son to the zoo. I'd love to contribute to this economy. Rhode Island is home to me. I love this state. I grew up in Providence. I graduated Hope High School in 1993, and I'm proud to say that I did. I love this state. I just want to see us do better, you know? We deserve it. Rhode Island deserves it. Our economy deserves it. Thank you.